Vault is a little different. We don't have a basket to dunk on, an end zone to run into, or a goal to shoot in. Our sport involves three things: a pole, a bar, and our teammates. With vaulting, there's an abnormal objective. Simply put, we like to get high. No, not from drugs or things like that. Instead, we live off an adrenaline rush, throwing ourselves up in the air, as high as we can, so we can fall as far and as long as possible. I never really was into track when I was younger. I played baseball. Lots and lots of baseball. Over the past few years, I've gotten into soccer and have gotten fairly good, I think. But it wasn't until my sophomore year that I really got into track and field. Until then, my only previous experience with track had been watching the Olympics on TV, and that's about it. I didn't even plan on doing it in high school, but having a bad experience with high school baseball my freshman year, I thought I'd give it a go. Jaren was the one that convinced me to come try pole vault. Beforehand, I didn't know too much about the sport. I mean, I knew what it was and what vaulters did to get over the bar. They ran, jammed a pole in the ground, and jumped as high as they could. Shortly after trying out, I learned that there was much, much more to it than that. What first got you into pole vaulting?
I was just kind of pulled into it. My brother did it before me, and when I tried out my freshman year, I was just pulled into it.
It all started when my brother, Jordan Blewett, he started in 2012. He did it in his senior year. He was the first person to be taught pole vault by Coach Carter, and he was hooked on it. He told me about it, and I figured, why not try it? So here I am.
So I really love beating Jaren and everything, because he's my best friend. And so I wanted to start pole vaulting just so I could beat Jaren in something.
I quickly learned that pole vault was not as cut and dry as I thought. I was presented with one of the hardest things I had ever done, and I wanted to be good. What most people don't realize is there's a lot of work that goes into the sport that's often unseen.
Oh, you can just run down and jump. I could do that. But then, like, it's not. You can't do that. It's not that easy.
It's not a sport of laziness. People, when they look at us doing our workouts, we're holding a pole, we're doing some little short runs. Nothing as bad as a mile or sprinting for too long, but it's a lot of hard work.
It's not as easy as it looks. You might be like, oh, I can do that. Like, you could try, but it's not that easy. It's a lot of work.
First, you have to be physically fit. The sport requires a ridiculously strong core, and this means not only being able to run quickly, but also having the ability to control your body. Thus, a frequent core workout is necessary. Next comes the relentless repetition of small skills. Running with the pole, planting and driving properly, swinging upside down, and kicking out to get over the bar. Then comes the hardest part, retraining your brain. Naturally, as humans, we are not made to travel vertically upside down, 12 feet over the ground. Because of this, getting your brain and body to think like a vaulter is easily the hardest thing in the sport. More often than not, this is why we don't get over the bar. What our brain wants our body to do and what our body actually wants to do are two completely different things. And that is exactly why we are often seen as the crazy bunch. Not everyone does what we do, and it's not just because it is difficult. More often than not, it is because what we do is in fact crazy. Bonkers. Bananas. Whatever you'd like to call it. But to us, it makes perfect sense.
Many of us do it for different reasons.
To prove something to myself and to others. I'm a pretty short guy, so when they see this little ball flying through the air, it makes people, like, their jaws drop. I like that. And my jaw drops too, because it's just something I'd never expect from myself.
I have to say I like the thrill of jumping high and landing on a mat. I don't know how else to explain it. It's thrilling, that's why.
So I can fly in through the air, get stronger, and, you know, get stronger, you can get girls really easily, and also be Jaren up.
I do it simply to escape the world beneath me for as long as possible. There's a feeling once you're up in the air that the few seconds between takeoff and touchdown are euphoric. and I just want to experience them for as long as possible. And that right there is not just why I pole vault, but my favorite thing about it.
When you get over the bar at meets, you're falling down, you're looking up at the bar, and you see it staying there, and it's just like, I made it, I did it, and then you just gotta do it the next time. Alright.
Over the past year, I've fallen in love with a sport that I barely understood. You may be wondering why there isn't any footage of me in this video. To simply put it, I had a rough season. And that happens, everyone hits a mental block every so often. Mine just happened to be pretty bad. It was still alright though, because I never gave up on the sport. More importantly, I got to spend so much more time with friends I never would have had originally and became part of the vaulting family, which I wouldn't trade that for anything. That said, I don't want the statement of my failure this spring to degrade the success my other teammates had. We sent all three of our competing boys vaulters to state. As well as Tori Ochoa for girls. Ben Switzman, one of my really good friends, went to and secured 6th place at the state meet after his second outdoor track season with the sport. Adam Maggard took 5th, securing himself in the top 5 in the state and finishing his high school vaulting career at a 12-6 jump. And Jaron Baluyat, Filipino wonder kid in the 11th grade, became state champion for his 3rd track season in a row. Even though the program has finished its season with one of the best years so far, I only have one last thing to say. From here, we just keep going up.
So, post states, how are you feeling?
So tired.
There's always room for improvement. Always.
There's always.
I already said that.
He's mumbling.
Always.
Classic.
Explain to me why there's a bow tie around your neck.
Because I wore it to school. Why aren't you classy?
I'm always classy. What you mean?
I'm always classy. I'm in the battery back. Yeah, you sound assy. But I ain't got first class.
I hate you.
Is there anything any of you guys want the viewers to know?
There's nothing better than the end of a season. But there is one, the start of a season. Yes.
What does that even mean?
It can only be an end.
The end is only just a beginning.
That's a question for the viewers.
Or is it?
An end is only.
It's the beginning.
Adam, do you have any thoughts to say about your last vaults at Broadneck High School?
I'm gonna cry. I don't want to think about that. That's depressing.
Oh, sweet Jesus.
Just anything you can get out before tears.
I mean, I'm not even gonna cry.
If you know.
Save me.
I mean, it's been an experience. It's something different. Not a lot of people do this.
Keep asking him questions. Get a tear to come out.
You won't be able. You won't be able to get me to cry.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Really? Yeah.
When's the next time you're going to see Coach Carter?
Next week.
That's true.
How's it feel to be the only senior in the pole vault squad?
I don't know. I got to be the captain, so that's pretty cool. You won't be able to do it, bet. I'm made of stone.
Has your journey getting here been rough or smooth? Do you think?
You know the answer.
We need context
that
here.
That makes me angry.
Give us context.
No.
Do you believe?
We're supposed to leave until we leave.
Do you believe in the saying, hard work pays off?
Yeah, I do.
Why?
I don't know. Probably because I was cut twice.
Yeah.
Maybe something to do with that.
That's that. Until next season.
Cue breakfast club song. Don't.